our strength come from the mountains? No. Our strength comes from God, who made heaven and earth and mountains. We dedicate this song to Renee, Jason, Nask, in loving memory of their son, Jack. One more time for Jack Sparrow, ladies and gentlemen. We jump for this. Thank you, Karen. That's a beautiful thing to sing in your life. You can take a seat. So we've established we're originally from Australia. We live in originally from Nashville. We now live in Nashville, Tennessee. And I got to tell you, we love the great United States of America. Let's give a cheer for America, ladies and gentlemen. In fact, my parents, they just became citizens recently, and yes they did. And they were so thrilled because last week they got to vote for the very first time in their lives, and it's a distinct privilege. I live in a town just south of Nashville called Franklin, Tennessee, and it's a lovely spot if you're to one person that's been there before. I think Australia and America have a lot of things in common. but there is one disconnect, and that is our English dialect. You see, because, I've studied this a fair amount in the South. Australians are lazy people, okay? We abbreviate everything. For instance, I'll give you a few examples. We call McDonald's Maccas, we call breakfast brekkie, we call biscuits bickies, chickens chickies. Basically, add an E to any word. That's what we do. Just out of pure laziness. So this will not be an uncommon conversation with me and my cousin. You know, we're going to the beach, it's first thing in the morning, and we're going for a surf, and we haven't had any breakfast yet, and my cousin looks at me, he's like, and mind you, we're driving on the left side of the road just to paint him a picture. So he's like, mate, I got an idea. I'm like, yeah, mate, what's up? He's like, pull a Yui, let's go to Macca's for brekkie and get a chicky bicky. Yeah! Actually, when I moved over here, I realized how preposterous those sorts of statements were. But on the contrary, in at least in the South, they add syllables to words that don't belong. And you're laughing because you know what I mean. Like, for instance, I have a friend, his name is Van. It's a three-letter word, very simple word. And he told me the other day that he can sort of rate how happy or unhappy his wife is by how many syllables she applies to his name. So if she's just right as rain, it's just Van. Hi Van, how are you, Van? I love you, Van. And if she's sort of moderately serious, it becomes Van, come Van. And if she's really ropeable, as we would say, really upset, it becomes three syllables, my friends. It becomes Van, what are you? Like, that's a three-letter word into three syllables. That's making it so much more complicated than it deserves to be. But I have to give them credit. Let's give the South credit, you know. Fried food and extra syllables. It's a lot of things. No, we love the South. In fact, a lot of the stories that we've shared tonight, a lot of the songs that we've written have been out of time spent in the South and in the United States and rising from being here in America. And it's interesting, I found myself taking so much pride in this great country. And I find myself really feeling things, and sometimes not good things, in relation to where we find ourselves. And I gotta tell you, I feel like in looking at it, particularly the last few years, it feels like we're coming to a boiling point in certain ways. We've got, obviously, we're, 3 days shy of electing a new president. There's this tension, this political division that seems to be amongst us. And there's this international extremism that we face that feels like it's encroaching on our shores. And there's this racial tension that is rising up. And it feels like it's coming to sort of a boiling point. I remember it was Independence Day week. If you recall, there were shootings that week in Dallas. Police officers had passed away, African American men had passed away. And we had a show with KB that Friday. And I remember seeing him that morning, and I went up to him and said, you know, how you going, man? And he just looked at me in the eyes and he said, I'm struggling. And we went, and we, some of the band guys, myself and he, we sat down, and for about 2 hours we talked. And I gotta tell you, I cried that day. I cried because of my own naivety. I cried because here I am, basically being in this country on and off since I was 7 years old, and I had no idea about the realities, the facefulness. It feels as though we're at a crossroads, you know? On one hand, we can lean into that feeling, the anger, the frustration, the fear, division. But I do believe there's another way, and I don't think it's dependent on who is the commander-in-chief or the political environment or the social environment in this country. I believe, my friends, it starts here. You realize this is a wonderful, historic moment. For one time in the history of the world, this combination of people is gathered together in this room, and it will never happen again. As we march out these doors in just a few short moments into the future, across this state and around the country, as we move on, I hope that this will be our charge, that we will not fix our eyes on division or on what divides us, or on fear, or anger, frustration. On the contrary, I hope and we pray that we will fix our eyes on one thing, the greatest thing that has united humanity for the last 2,000 years, that we will look up and we'll fix our eyes on nothing else and nothing less than on Jesus Christ. And now, my friends, thank you so much for being with us.